So how many of you feel that you work hard, that you are a hard worker, that you lay it all on the line for your job, for your career, for your boss, for your business, for your team? Well, I spent 8 years in the Marine Corps. You know what I found out? I look back, I got nothing to show for, but I have everything to owe for. So in this video, I will share with you five industries that are most likely in the next 5, 7, 10 years to help you become a first generation cash flow millionaire. Which ones? Stay tuned. Let's get started in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jada. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger. Just fighting in them trenches, now I'm making 7 figures like.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from Dallas, Texas. And if you haven't done so already, our journey is to get to 150,000 subs. Why? Because we want to award a church, charity, or nonprofit $5,000 on behalf of the squad. That's right. Between me and you, we call it a 7-figure squad. And we want to help other people, but we got to get to 150,000 subs. So if you haven't done so already, and I'm showing value in this video and to help you out and gain some insight into some things, please click like and subscribe. So I want to share with you five industries that if you work hard and bust your tail in it, it most likely will help you become a first generation cash flow millionaire. I'm also going to break it down into multiple things. I'm going to break it down in terms of capital necessary to start this business, when you start receiving cash flow from this business, and what type of contacts that you need in this business to help you get started. Okay, number five on the list, education and training service. What did the pandemic teach us all? We want services. We want education. We want tutoring. We want some assistance. So when I'm looking at this industry, this is what it all involves. Education training services is a broad industry where you can apply your knowledge and expertise in what you know about that particular area. Whether it's tutoring high school students or starting an instructional school like dance academy or driving school, this is one of the fastest growing sectors in the world. So what does it take to start this type of business up? I'd say between $500 and $1,000, conservatively speaking. Enough for marketing materials, perhaps, maybe business cards, a simple one-page website. So it's relatively a very inexpensive business to start. Now, when do you get paid? When do you start cash flowing? Well, when you put together your first class, when you finally close on a client, when you finally sell your service to fix somebody's problem or desire to improve in a certain area, you say, hey, I can help you in that. Now, if you're watching this and you're realizing, man, I don't have the capital. I don't have the $500. I don't have $1,000. Put in the comment section below, I am saving capital to invest. I am saving capital to invest. And so what type of context do you need? Anybody that wants to improve in that area. I can't tell how many times people like myself are always asking for ideas that relates to TikTok, as it relates to Instagram, as it relates to social media, to brand ourselves, and what you're already doing. For those of you in your junior high or high school years, I remember one time for my wife's birthday, I hired a high school band to come out and wish her a happy birthday. And I got to know these two teenagers. I said, listen, man, I want to be your side hustle. Show me a way I can brand myself on TikTok or on social media, and I gladly pay you for your hour or 2 hours of time, which is something you're already doing for fun. Number four, investment firm. Listen, right now, there's a massive amount of wealth from the greatest generation, people in their 70s and 80s, down to the baby boomer generation. And here in the next 5 or 6 years, from the baby boomer generation into the greatest population right now coming up, which is a Generation X. And guess who's a massive amount of generation right after the Generation X? It's the millennials. So if you find yourself with a desire to learn about money and teach people about money and learn about investments and how to put their money in, set up asset allocation and dollar cost averaging type of strategies. Hey, knock yourself out in the investment industry, learning how to be a professional investment advisor. And what happens is you can call all your friends. Hey, listen, let's go have a firm that teaches people about and educates people about money. So the cost to start this type of business, anywhere between $500,000 to get your licenses. Again, word of mouth type of business, basic marketing materials, some one-page website to get started, Instagram, Facebook, enough to get the word out. You constantly upload content. And in terms of cash flow, as soon as their client accounts, they put their money from one brokerage account, from their bank account, from their checking account, into the brokerage accounts that you help set up. With most broker dealers, most wirehouses, they pay you immediately within the next 24, 48 hours. So if this is starting to make sense to you, put it in the comment section as an affirmation. I am picking the right industry to become a millionaire in 2022. I am picking the right industry to be a millionaire in 2022. And in terms of contacts, what type of contacts do you need? Well, in an investment world, to have a profitable book of business, to make it worth your time and worth your while, most likely you're looking for clients that can invest $250,000 or more into an account that you set up. Number three, people are saying, you know what? I'm going to get my own business started. So guess what they need? They need a business consultant. So you have any experience on any area of business, setting up a corporation, helping people do their taxes, marketing, social media, video, audio, podcasts, you can put yourself in a position to help out that business owner. Again, because this is a service-based type of business, it doesn't cost you very much money to get this business started. Again, I'd roughly estimate between $1,000 and potentially $5,000 to have some really robust marketing materials to set yourself apart from anybody else that's on Instagram, and having some due diligence and, more importantly, some training so you can find a niche within inside the business consulting world. So therefore, you can be the obvious choice when it comes to this problem that people are looking for, and you provide an obvious solution. Okay, quick pause. If you're getting excited about rounding, you get your creative juices flowing, put it in the comment section below. I am creating cash flow in 2022. I am creating cash flow in 2022. So cash flow-wise, when do you start making money? Again, it's a service-based business. Once you deliver your services and you have an agreement that you provide these services, guess what? You get paid immediately. And in terms of context, who do you need? Talk to, ask for referrals. Talk to a business lawyer that's setting up corporations. Talk to a CPA. Talk to a tax preparer that's establishing tax returns for business owners. Place where you go for a haircut, ask the barbershop owner. Ask the hair salon owner. The place where you go get oil changes, ask the garage owner. The place where you go to a gym, ask the gym owner. The place where you go eat, you talk to the restaurant owner. You see what I'm talking about? And you start building a clientele of people that are business owners. And once you find out what their biggest problem is, you ask them a question. What keeps you up at night? Very simple. What keeps you up at night? What is your solution to fix that problem? So if you want to become a first generation cash flow millionaire in the next 3, 4, 5 years, consider becoming a business consultant. Number two, elder care. Now, I mentioned a couple industries ago that one of the greatest industries to get involved in because of the changing demographics and the population that's aging, needing to retire because they're getting older, is getting involved in starting an investment firm. Well, guess what? If you're providing them quality money, guess what people usually spend with that quality money? Quality care, lifestyle. In this case, elder care. And I'm sitting in a situation, I'm telling myself, man, if I'm busy raising my own 5 kids, I don't want my parents to be left alone. I have to hire, if I'm not doing it, I have to hire somebody that I trust that will take care of my mom and dad in case I can't take care of them because I get my own busy life Monday through Friday. I can, of course, visit them midpoint throughout the week or at the weekend, but every day, in the middle of the night, in the middle of the day, no, I can't be there. So consider building a business in the elder care industry. Now, the cost to start this type of business, anywhere between $500 and $5,000, depending on the license that you need in your state. But here's the thing too as well. You have to have some context and understanding how your state Medicaid system works and how the Medicare system works too as well. You have to have the understanding of how hospitals will discharge older patients. And in regards to cash flow, well, just like any medical bill, you provide the quality of care and either you bill the insurance company and you bill them for their deductible and the difference of what the insurance company didn't bill. But that's something you have to now create as infrastructure in terms of medical billing to make sure as you provide these services, you also get paid. Now, who are the contacts for you to get these type of clients? Talk to discharge nurses. Talk to people with older parents, just like myself, who are facing these type of predicaments. Even talk to people that own funeral homes because they know a lot of people in the community with people that are in the older population. Quick pause. If you're anything like me, when I started my business and I thought all my friends and family would help me after serving 8 years in the Marines and I found out that they weren't, put in the comment section below. I am seeking better contacts in 2022. I am seeking better contacts in 2022. And last but not least, number one, industry most likely to make you a millionaire in the next 5, 7, 10 years, bing, 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 it is financial services. And what exactly is financial services? Anything related to the movement of money from institutions to the consumer. It could be credit repair. It could be tax preparation. It could be accounting, bookkeeping. It could be providing insurance. It could be providing retirement services. It could be providing mortgages. Just keep this in mind. There's always money to be made in money, financial services. So if you're looking out there to say, you know, what industry can I take my time and talents and my hardcore work ethic and actually have something to show for the next 5, 7, 10 years? Well, financial services numero uno on a list of industries most likely to make you a millionaire. So, in terms of cash flow, when do you get paid? Well, again, when the transaction happens. When you sell the life insurance policy and they get the policy approved, most likely insurance companies will then send you a commission. So whatever you desire and how you get paid when the transaction closes in that general scope, whether it's immediate because it's hand-to-hand type of transaction or you're waiting on an insurance company to pay you, generally speaking, it's between immediately and 30 to 45 days. So in financial services, how much capital do you need to get this business started? Again, between $500 and $1,000 to get your proper licenses with the lines of financial services that you'd like to offer. And what type of context do you need to get this type of business up off the ground? Well, what's that saying? There's nothing as certain as death and taxes. So if you know somebody that one day feels that they're going to pass away, that's a client. If you know that somebody that's making money has to file the taxes, that's a client. If you know somebody that wants to buy a house, and they need to either improve their credit and or want to get a mortgage, that's a client. All you need to do is find people that want to financially improve their life. So who's your market? Practically everybody. So as I wrap up, I have one last bit of information I want to share with you. Just want to let you know, you can go out there, you can start yourself an education training service, you can start yourself an investment firm, you can start yourself a business consultancy, you can set yourself up in an elder care business, you can set yourself up in financial services type of business, but you won't get to become a millionaire until you actually build a team. If you want to become a millionaire and stay a millionaire, it's not becoming a self-made millionaire. It's all about being a team-made millionaire. So if you want to know how I built myself a multi-million dollar business with less than $500, check out this video right here. And this other video right here is how to actually do the millionaire math, so therefore you become a millionaire. That being said, I love to know your thoughts, your comments, your feedback. Please put it in the comment section below. If you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. And if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click like, subscribe, and hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. From Dallas, Texas, I'm your Money Smart Guy. And until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today. See you tomorrow.